I'm going to walk you through all the main events that took the computer from a simple knitting machine to an awesome piece of technology that supports machine learning and AI. Stay tuned till the end of the video for a bonus fact. And we're starting right now. Computers are being applied in all various fields, and new applications are emerging day after day. Scientists, for example, apply it to prediction of weather, earthquakes, and storms, to control satellites, and to control atomic reactions in reactors. Engineers use it in designing cars, airplanes, ships, buildings, bridges, tools, you name it. It all started around only 2 centuries ago, in 1801, with Joseph-Marie Jacquard, a French inventor, while he designed a knitting machine that uses punched wooden cards to produce fabric with complex patterns and designs. These punch cards were then used by early computers, like the popular Turing machine that was built in 1936 by the famous Alan Turing. And for those who don't know what is the Turing machine, well, actually it's a machine used by the Allies during World War II to decrypt the encrypted Nazi communication, also known as the Enigma code. If you're interested to know more about this machine, let me know in the comments below and I will make a dedicated video about Alan Turing and his machine. Now back to our story. The first non-mechanical computer didn't appear until 1945 with the ENIAC. Back then, mechanical gears were swapped by vacuum tubes because they were much faster, and therefore the ENIAC could add up to 5,000 numbers in just 1 second. That doesn't seem much, right? But this computer took up an entire room and contained 18,000 vacuum tubes. And programming it was much different than what software developers do today. Workers had to plug cables into plug boards in a very specific order. Thankfully, this technology didn't last long, and in 1949, just 4 years later, the EDVAC, an improvement of the ENIAC, was built and used transistors instead of vacuum tubes. Therefore, the EDVAC was considered the first binary computer. A decade later, in 1959, Robert Noyce grouped on a single silicon chip a bunch of small transistors and created the first integrated circuit called the Noyce's monolithic IC, which by the way is still used as a base for modern integrated circuit chips. IC chips were outperforming traditional transistors since they were faster and much more efficient. In 1971, as manufacturing technology improved, Intel upped the game again by including on a single silicon chip not thousands of transistors but thousands of integrated circuits and released the first ever true microprocessor, the Intel 4004. Packaged on a 2 cm silicon chip, it had the same computing power as the room-sized ENIAC. Microprocessors are still evolving today. Your average personal computer would have around 6 to 8 high-performance microprocessing cores, known as the CPU, and anywhere from 400 to more than 4000 low-performance cores, known as the GPU. We are now able to perform much more complex tasks, such as machine learning and AI. However, many scientists are working on what is believed to be the next milestone in computing, quantum computers. Let me know in the comments below if you think that quantum computing is going to actually be the next big thing. Now it's time for the bonus fact. Did you know that an iPhone 11 Pro Max has more than 290,000 times the compute capabilities and 7.12 million times the memory capacity of the NASA Apollo 11 guidance computer? And if you don't know what is the Apollo 11, well, it's actually the rocket that made the man's first step on the moon possible. If you want to dive deeper and understand the technical side of computers, make sure to continue watching this playlist right here. And if you don't want to miss any of the future episodes of this educational series, make sure to subscribe. Hopefully, I will see you in the next episode.